Good day, wonderful people of the Real International School and my esteemed parents. How are you coping with the ongoing lockdown? I guess you are enjoying yourself and I hope you are safe. By the grace of God, we believe that in the next few months or days from now, God is going to release the cure of COVID-19 to relieve us this body in Jesus' name. Amen. Alright, I'm not a prophet, I'm Mr. Godwin, and I'm here to take you on mathematics. The topic we have today is on calculation of profit and loss. Calculation of profit and loss. We know we have potential great businessmen of tomorrow. So that is why we are here to help you to work toward achieving that dream by bringing this topic to help you know the basics of a business and how to run your business and make your profits. So today we are going to look at calculation of profit and loss. And the first thing I'm going to look at here is the difference between profit and loss, as well as the formulas, also the different formulas for profit and loss. But before then, let's look at cost, price, and selling price. Cost price is equal to CP. Please note this from the beginning. Cost price is equal to CP because we are going to be using the abbreviations. We are going to be working with the abbreviations, sorry. So you have to get used to them, as we are going to be using them in calculation. So cost price is equal to what? CP. Please take note of that. Cost price is equal to what? CP. And selling price is equal to what? SP. Selling price is equal to what? SP. Alright. I said before we look at the difference between profit and loss, we are going to look at the difference between cost price and selling price. What is cost price? Cost price is the price at which a buyer buys or purchases his commodities from the market. Cost price is the price at which a buyer purchases his commodities from the market. Before a businessman sells, he has to buy, isn't it? Before a businessman sells anything, he has to go to the market and get it and buy it at a price called cost price. At a price called what? Cost price. Please take note of that. The price at which a businessman or trader buys or purchases his commodity from the market is called the cost price. Take note of that. And after purchasing the commodity, he takes it home and adds additional money called profit to the money, to the cost price, in order to make his own gain. And that changes the price, or that makes him to sell his commodity above the cost price in order to make a profit or gain. Alright, the price at which he's going to sell it out is called the selling price, known as SP. The selling price. SP, the selling price. The selling price is the price at which a trader or businessman or woman sells his commodity, which he purchased from the market. The selling price is the price at which a trader or businessman sells his commodity, which he purchased from the market to his customer. So you need to take note of that. So the next thing I need to look at is the profit, the difference between profit and loss. What is profit? Alright, profit is the additional money a trader makes after the sale of a commodity. And it is calculated as follows. Profit is equal to selling price minus cost price. Profit is equal to selling price minus cost price. Please take note of this as we are going to go into calculations related to this topic. We are going to be using this formula. We are going to be using this formula for calculating our profit. So please take note of this formula. Profit is equal to what? Selling price minus cost price. Profit is equal to what? Selling price minus cost price. Alright, the next thing we are going to look at is the loss. Alright, one incurs loss when he or she, as a businessman or woman, sells his commodity below the cost price. Loss is incurred when a commodity is sold below the cost price. Alright, and it's calculated as follows. Loss is equal to cost price minus selling price. Loss is equal to cost price minus selling price. I know no businessman will want to lose. No businessman will want to lose. But it's inevitable as a businessman, for sure. You cannot avoid it. Because as a businessman, at times you make or you incur losses. So you have to know how to calculate your loss as well as your profit. So next we are going to go into the full calculation of, we are going to go into problems relating to this topic. Alright, we are going to start this way with a question, or let's call it examples. Example 1. Example 1. Mr. Tunde bought a share for 500 naira. Mr. Tunde bought a share for 500 naira and sold it because he's looking for profit. He added additional money to the cost, to the cost price, and sold it at the price of 550 naira. How much profit has he made? Alright, you can see the clothes, you can see the money, you've seen the money here. He bought the share at 500 naira and he sold it at 550 naira. How much profit has he made? You can see how much money has been added to the money he used to buy the cloth. 15 naira, I guess. Guess you are saying the same thing. 15 naira is the additional money. That is, his profit is 15 naira. We haven't done any calculation yet. It's just the description of what profit is all about. We are going to go into full calculation of what we have just demonstrated here. So, Mr. Tunde bought a share for at 500 naira and sold it at 550 naira. how much roughly as he made. Alright, we just demonstrated it. But what you are going to do now, you are going to calculate it. You are going to go into calculation to prove how we got this 50 naira as his profit. So, what's our formula for profit? Alright, if you say profit is equal to selling price equals to profit is equal to selling price minus cost price, you were very correct. And just put your hands together for yourself. Alright, we are going to proceed here. Profit is equal to selling price minus cost price. Profit is equal to selling price minus cost price. All right, looking at the question, what is our selling price there? Mr. Tunde bought. The price at which he bought the cloth is called the cost price. And then the price at which he sold, Mr. Tunde bought a shirt at 500 naira and sold it at 550 naira. The selling price is the price at which he sold the clothes to his customer. So the selling price is 550 naira. So we have here selling price. Our selling price is we will be using 100 tens and units to solve here. So take note of the arrangement.
Okay, set.
All right. The next thing is our cost price. Our cost price is what? That's the price at which he bought the commodity from the market. Is what? 500 naira. So, and our profit. So, what we have here is selling price up. Please, you must arrange your work well. Selling price minus the cost price. Just like we have here from the formula. Profit is equal to selling price minus cost price. It's just a kind of arrangement, a different arrangement here. Please take note of that. So, the next thing I'm going to do is to subtract now. Starting from your extreme right. Zero take away zero. I know you know that. Zero take away zero is zero. And five take away zero is what? Five. And five take away five is what? Zero. You don't write it. You don't have to write a zero there. Alright, you can see how we got the 50 naira profit. Or how he got this 50 naira profit. Alright, the next we are going to look at example 2. Example 2. Mr. John bought a polish for 100 naira and sold it at 150 naira. How much profit has he made? You can see from the demonstration. The cost price is 100 naira, the selling price is 150 naira, and he made an additional money of 50 naira. So we are going to calculate it out now. What is his profit? And how much profit has he made? Alright. Formula for profit is what? Profit is equal to selling price. We can use SP for selling price. We shorten the whole thing. SP minus CP for cost price, and then we arrange here SP is equal to what? From the question, the selling price is 150 naira. And the cost price CP is 100 naira. And our profit, or his profit, sorry, is equal to. Alright, to get the profit, we have to calculate, we have to subtract the cost price from the selling price. Zero take away zero is zero. Alright, five take away zero is what? Five. And one take away one is zero. So that is how we arrive at this profit. So the next thing we are going to look at is calculation on loss. Or calculation on loss. And we know that the formula for calculating loss is cost price minus selling price. I told you that nobody wants to lose in business, but as a businessman, you cannot avoid losses, because at the time you will sell and you make losses. So you have to know how to calculate your losses. So one incurs loss when he or she sells a commodity below the cost price, which is not good for a businessman. So we are going to look at this question. Miss Jane, or let's still use polish. Mr. John bought a polish for 100 naira and he bought it at 100 naira, that is the cost price, and he sold it at 50 naira instead of adding additional money to the cost price. He sold it below the cost price. So he has incurred losses. He lost in the business. Sad for him. So we are going to look at the calculation here and know how much he lost. Example 3, still under calculation of profit and loss. Mr. John bought the product at 100 naira and sold it at 15 naira. What is this? All right, we're still going to arrange it the way we arrange the others. That is, now since the cost price is higher or greater than the selling price. So that's why you have the formula for loss to be cost price minus selling price. So we are going to bring the cost price first because the price there is greater. Let's use CP for cost price. Let's use CP for cost price. The cost price is what?